Hi guys, MOG here. Welcome to another video. In this video, I am covering on how you can manage data usage on your mobile devices using an app called DataEye. The DataEye is available on Android devices and you can download it using the Play Store. Once you install and open the app, you will have two tabs. One of them is called Usage and other one is called Control. So there is a data saving mode under usage, and we're gonna discuss that in a bit on how it works. But looking down, we have data used since November 1st. And if I click on it, I can actually see usage in a bit more detail in the last 24 hours and what apps were being used. So as you guys can see, I did a lot of speed test. I did a bit of Chrome browsing. And all of my usage was on my Wi-Fi network and none of it was on mobile data. I can also see what happened in the last hour, and it looks like I was just using Chrome pretty much at that time. I can go up to 12 days and see what usage I had. And it also shows me blog requests and how much data I was able to save with the app. Going back, it shows top Wi-Fi usage, which is something we looked already in detail before. Now, what the data saving mode actually does is when you enable it, it routes all your data usage through the DataEye app, and it gives you a little bit more control on what apps should be using data services. So if I click on control, DataEye is right now telling me that only Google Backup Transport and Google Play Store are allowed access to the network, while other system apps and other apps do not have any access. And it also tells me what services recently tried to connect to data, and they were blocked at what time and date. Now, if I want to give them access, all I have to do is just select, and in this case, Facebook services will have access to data now, so I will be able to receive messages or any other type of updates as well. And in case I do not want, I can just disable it back and it will get blocked if it tries to access data again. Now, in case you looked in the previous usage tab, you might have noticed that it says data used since November 1st. And in certain cases, you might have your billing period, let's say, with a different time period. And you can actually go in settings of the app to set it accordingly. So let's say if your billing period is 15th of November, then you can just set it to 15th and data usage will be tracked based on that time period now. You can also enable the data, the auto start option, which will enable DataEye as soon as you power up your phone. You can also enable DataEye to manage your traffic on Wi-Fi. So in my current case, because I have unlimited internet, I've just set it to disable, but if I am on a network that has a limited data cap, then I can enable it. With the current control settings that I have, only Google Play Store and Backup Transport have access to data services, and that might be a bit too restrictive because a regular user might want to browse internet. So in that case, let's say if you're using Chrome browser, then you will need to enable it. And let's say I want my WhatsApp to be accessible as well when I am using data, I can enable it. So let's go down. that's it. So only these four services will have access when I'm using data services, and the other ones will get blocked. And that's it, guys. In case you're looking to optimize your data usage, you can always go back in statistics and see that in detail. I hope you guys find this video very useful. Thank you. Bye.